Hi all, today with the new features of SQL Server 2016, we come up with a new topic, Always Encrypted. So, what is Always Encrypted? Always Encrypted is a new features, new security features that ensure that all the data which we kept in database would be always in encrypted format. And it would always be remain for all time. So now if we will see the pictures which is given here, so there are two states of data. One is data in motion and second is data at rest. The data in motion, so whenever we are traversing one data from one location to another location, like here you can see the database which kept the data in rest states, and now any of the applications try to access this data, then the same data would be on data in motion state. So by using these techniques, we will ensuring that the data at rest levels would always be encrypted. Now, what are the advantages of using these techniques? So there would be clear separations between the persons who is owning the data and the persons who is managing the data. Like TBA system admins and cloud admins cannot access those data even if they have the access of resources. Now you can see, if we keep the data in a plain text, the tables would be like this, in which we have all the data in the plain text. You can see the credit card information over here and the email information. Now by using these techniques, you can see how the credit card information and the email encrypted. Now even if the system admins or the DBA have the access of these tables, they cannot code the actual information of credit card and email. So now let's see how it's work. So client drivers encrypt the data, the applications which interact with the database connect through any of the drivers, any of the providers, and this is the role of the drivers or the providers which encrypt the data. Now, how they encrypt the data? So based on the master key. Master key is a digital certificate which is located on both of the database side and the client end side. Now, these digital certificates could be stored in any of these three locations. One is local key stores, which is by default provided by the Windows certificate stores. Second one is HSMs. Well-known hardware security modules provided by third parties like SafeNets, by using which you can store any of the digital certificates and in private key inside it in a network and you can access easily. And now the third one is Azure Works. Nowadays the Microsofts provide these solutions to manage the certificates inside the cloud. So, and the fourth thing which is important, which is column key. We'll see what is master key and the column key. So the column key protect the data, column key protect the data, and the master key protect the columns encryption key. To know more about the column and master encryption, we would have to see any actions in the database. Like if we see, we have one tables, personal information which contain the same ID, gender, certificate, credit card, salary, and email. And you can see we have inserted this value, and by using this select query, we can get this information easily. Now what I want, I just want to encrypt the credit card information and the email information. So for this, where I should go, I will click on the table which I have created, and then right click, and we have one new feature here, encrypted columns. So I have clicked on next. You can see CEK auto new. Here the keyword is new. It means that we are going to create a master key and the column key for these columns. So I just click on credit card and email. Now choose the type. In type, we have two options. One is deterministic and second is randomization. If we want to search the data and if we want to group the data, then we will go with the deterministics. Otherwise, we will go with the randomize. So with the email, I am also going to use deterministics. So for examples, we can take here like salary, we are using randomization. So the salary is would be encrypted, but the encrypted value would be the different. So on that case, I have chosen randomized, and now it will create a new master key. So I just click on next, and it will store into the Windows certificate store. So where it is, I am just going to certmanager.msc, and now you can see here it should not take too much time, but it took. So let's see. Again, I clicked on OK. Either it opened or not. No, not open. Oh, now it opened. So you can see here are all the certificates which contains here. If we have CA certificates, if we have intermediate certificates, then it's all would be available over here. So now I am just looking into my personal certificates. So here we have only two certificates. Now what I am going to do, just creating a new master key for the current users. So the for the current users, it will go into personal, and now I am finishing the process. So CMK Auto 1 in window certificate store. If here we have multiple windows for the cert MDR MSC. So I am just going to close all those. Here we have two. Now I am refreshing. After refreshing, we saw that we have the newly created certificates, always auto certificate encrypted here, and now I'm going to always encrypted wizards. It's completed here. So all three pages are passed, and now in SQL servers, what we are going to do, I'm just going to re-execute the same query. So after the execution of this query, we found that the credit card information which was there in plain text and the emails which were there in plain text is now encrypted. And apart from that, I could found the keys, the master key and the column encryption key here. So if we will click on column encryption key and properties, what we will see, I have used the credit card, salary and email columns with the, these encryption types, and the algorithm is AES-256. So for your kind information, I just want to tell you that currently Microsoft is using AES algorithms only for the column encryption. So this is so simple. You can find out all the informations being encrypted just by configuring the simple steps of always encryption. Now how we could use this into any application, like C# application, C# console application. So I have just created a simple application. Here you can see, first of all, I just use the column encryption settings enabled. So the connection strings would be remain the same as it was before, but now we just add some enhanced property like column encryption settings. And if we will see for the read operations what we did, we didn't nothing. It is as same as before. For the insert, what we did, nothing. It is as same as before. And now I am trying to read the information of 1. So now we can see the data which is kept there in database in encrypted format, whereas whenever our applications try to get the data at the provider end, the data travels in encrypted format, but our providers decrypted, and now our applications have actual data over here. So this is really a good feature provided by the SQL Server. And now I am just going to change the property. So how, if like again, if we want the salary be back here in a plain text, then what should I do? I should just go on personal informations and encrypted columns, and here again by using this wizard I can change the type over here like plain text. So the salary is plain text again, and I just clicked on next. It will take some time to finish, and then after we will use the select query. Let's wait for some second. Oh, it's completed. Close the window. Again, I am going to query this. So again, salary is back. So this is very cool feature. I like very much, because previously there were many hurdles for storing the credit card informations, any essential informations like salary, email, and on that times we were using many of the customized encryption techniques to store the data into database, and again it was taking too much time and the performance was not good for the applications. Now yeah, if we talk about the performance of the applications, definitely because we are using encryption and decryption techniques on the basis of digital certificates, so it would be a little bit slow, but again the slowness of applications and the vulnerability are two different things. And yeah, by using these cool features we can secure our data easily in rest motion. Hope you enjoyed our video.